mind and heart are not two different things. In fact, heart is the purest form of mind, and the basic of mind is machine, is the lowest standard of it is machine. So it is somewhat contrary to our beliefs that we perceive that heart is something distinct from mind and which is full of emotions, whereas mind's job is to think and having thoughts and plans and all those things. So then again, when we moved ahead into that subject, it came, then we took heart as a distinct thing, what comes into heart and how heart reacts, it reacts illogically and all. So is it so that heart is nothing but mind, is the purest form of mind, or is it a different entity? Okay, but personally we feel that heart is something when
we don't feel that way, we have been fed that way.
Yes, that is also mentioned.
And lots of Hindi movie songs.
Yep. Biologically also we had this image, no, that when something starts beating over here, then we think that it's coming from the heart, and when it's from the head, we think that it's from mind. And we always had this impression, as I personally had this impression, that man or mind is what thinks, and the heart is what feels.
In fact, if you want to have a distinction between thinking and feeling, then that distinction, if fairly put, must be about putting thoughts on top and feelings on bottom. What you say is that the heart is higher than the mind, and the heart feels and the mind thinks. In saying that, you have put feeling on a pedestal higher than thought. The fact is, between thought and feeling, it's thought that actually deserves a higher position. If heart is truly to be higher than mind, then the heart cannot be a center of feeling, because feeling is lower than thought. If the heart truly is to be higher than mind, then the heart has to be the center of realization, not feeling. Even animals feel. Humans think. Buddhas realize. Now you see how these three are placed with respect to each other. Animals feel. Humans, Buddhas realize. So if the heart is to be highest, if the heart is to be the highest, then the heart has to be a center of
realization.
Instead, if you make the heart a center of feeling, then you have condemned the heart to be the lowest. On one hand, you say that the heart is higher than the mind. If the heart is higher than the mind, then the heart cannot be a center of feeling. Heart has to be a center of understanding and realization, which are not feelings.
Right, it's a perception.
No, not perception.
No, it's a new way of looking at it. On my body.
Simple
it's
fact.
It's a fact which we came to know about it. And that is why, I think that is why only sometimes heart is being considered so vulnerable. If we consider heart as we used to consider, sometimes it's in society it's considered to be more vulnerable than mind. In fact, people who are
Because the animal is more vulnerable than man, because the animal can be manipulated, and that's why man has been able to enslave animals, because all that the animal knows is its instincts, its intuition, its feelings. And instincts, intuition, feelings, they all belong to a lower level of being compared to thoughts. And higher than thoughts is realization, spirituality, meditation. But thoughts by themselves are very, very important. Thoughts are important because they rein in our animal instincts, our latent tendencies, our feelings, our instincts. Without thought, man would just be a creature of animal instincts, vrittis.
So as yesterday we were discussing that विचारों पे जो हम बात कर रहे थे, विचार के लेवल से हमको हार्ट के लेवल पे या रियलाइजेशन के लेवल पे आना होगा.
See, all these three are just mind. What are feelings?
Mind.
What are thoughts?
Mind.
What is realization? That too is mind.
Okay.
There is just mind. Whatsoever is mind. Whatsoever exists is just mind. But this mind itself has many grades. The lowest grade of mind is the mind that runs on tendencies, carnal tendencies. They are an even more primitive form of feelings. Even in the spectrum of feelings, there are carnal tendencies that are the lowest. And then there are the normal everyday feelings. Higher than tendencies and feelings are
thoughts.
Even among thoughts, there are several gradations. And then higher than all thoughts is
realization.
And all this is the wide spectrum of mind.
And then comes soul.
There is nothing called soul. There is just the mind.
Okay. So what is this concept of soul? Because people generally take a body, mind and soul, that's been
there is
mentioned.
Just the mind. Even the body is merely the mind.
Right. Thanks.
The purest point, the final point of mind is called the Atma or the Truth. That is the pinnacle of mind. And at its pinnacle, the mind disappears, just as the mountain disappears at the top.